So be careful how we ask God for stuff.
Amen.
And when we get there, we don't want to go through certain things. So I am getting the understanding of what it is. So I'm careful now of asking God for some stuff. So because she was favored, she went before the king when it was her turn to go see the king.
Amen, amen.
I learned a little thing there that each maiden, when it was their turn to go see the king, they were allowed to take something from where they were to take to the king. So I was thinking maybe to impress the king, you know. So I was thinking, what would I have bring, or what would I have brought to the king? Well, I'm beautiful already, you know that.
Yeah.
So I would have bring my beauty.
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit something else, you know, because you want to stand up. But Esther was advised not to bring anything.
Amen.
I said, God, why is she allowed to bring anything? Because when you go before the King of Kings, he has everything. We don't have to wait until we get house and land and husband and wife and odds and everything is okay. We can go just the way we are. And we can go before our King and we can say, here I am. So she stood up, and if you want to be noticed, you have to stand up.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
You have to purpose to stand up, because if everybody is alike, there's no difference.
Amen, amen, amen.
So she was a smart girl, and she stood up, and she was favored, and the king said, yes, this is the girl for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I don't think that Esther was the most beautiful girl among all the other girls. I don't think she was the most powerful girl. I don't think so. I don't think she was the most talented. No, I don't think so. But because she was favored, she was chosen. And if you're worried tonight, you go ask God to favor you.
Amen.
Yes. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And for some of us, you know, we want to wait until we become famous. Mm-hmm. For some of us, we want to wait until we store up a lot of wealth. Until, you know, we have our careers all done and everything, that's when we want to come before the king. But God is saying that now is the time. For such a time as this, it's right now that God is expecting us to stand up and say, I will do whatsoever you want me to do. And I will go wherever you want me to go. And I will say whatever that you want me to say. And I was thinking that all these ladies at Tabernacle of Praise that is in the palace for such a time as this. Do you know why you're in the palace? Do we know why God placed us at Tabernacle of Praise? I look young, but I'm a little bit old, okay? In church for a long time. And I hear all the excuses that we have. And it's always somebody else's fault.
Yeah.
It is never my fault.
Amen.
I blame the bishop. It's his fault. Because we don't want to take, we don't want to be accountable for our actions.
Amen.
And we come to church week after week complaining and complaining. Because somebody hurt me.
My mind.
Somebody said something about me.
My
and it's such a wasted time.
Amen.
It's such a wasted time when we come before God and we come complaining. God don't hear complainers.
Amen.
God only responds to faith. We waste complaining is a waste of our time.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Glory, Father, Lord, child. Hallelujah.
You know, we are all a part of this great family of God.
Glory to God.
And I want to encourage somebody tonight. That you're included in the work of God.
Yes, amen.
You are special to God.
Yes.
There is a purpose in your life.
Yes.
And I was thinking that all of us get to know what that purpose is.
Amen.
And we get busy doing what it is that God wants done in our life. We would tear the city upside down.
Hallelujah.
And I am not comfortable anymore just to go to church.
No.
And I was telling my husband the other day, and I'm gonna tell you exactly what I'm done with church. I'm going out to witness. Because all we do is get dressed and come and sit in church. And hear another message. And hear another message. And hear another message. And I wonder, what are we doing with the messages that we're getting?
Amen.
And God is saying, the time has come. The harvest is ripe.
Yes.
But the laborers are very few. Because we think that it should happen in this four wall. It's in here. But every time that they go in, God said, go out. When they come in, he said, come get and go.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to go and spread the gospel.
That's right.
And in these last days, we don't have a lot of time left.
Yes.
And we need to be talking to souls and win souls for the kingdom of God.
Yes.
So you're here at Tabernacle of Praise for such a time
as this.
Yes. And there is greatness in you. And some of us don't think we are worthy. And some of us think, let the past stop us from doing what God wants done. And we have our focus in the wrong place. And God wants us to change our focus and put it on what he wants done in our lives. And I was thinking, our focus should be. And we should be asking God questions like, what is my purpose? What contribution am I making to the kingdom of God? How many lives have I touched?
Hallelujah.
What kind of mark am I leaving here?
Hallelujah.
What legacy am I leaving for my children, for my grandchildren? What does God think about me? What is he saying to me? What it is that he wants me to do? These are the things that we should be concerned about. And I hear a lot of people, their concern have nothing to do with these things. You know what they're concerned about? Who is doing what? Who shouldn't be doing what? Why this one doing that? who all of these things that we nonsense that we spend time in the house of God. And God is saying that it is a personal, personal relationship that He wants with us. And we have to decide that I'm going to make it about me. I will make it. Now is the time for you to approach your King. Oh, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And Esther didn't just run before the king, you know. You know what she did? She called a fasting.
Yes, amen.
And praying.
Yes.
Yeah.
I said to somebody 2 days ago when they called me, I said, I thought you were calling for fasting and prayer. But the situation was very serious. It was a serious situation. But the person didn't want fasting and prayer, want the flesh to deal with it. And I was saying, she didn't only fast and pray with her maidens. She said to Mordecai, get everybody in town. Everybody needs to fast and pray so that we can get the breakthrough.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. But I want to demonstrate a little bit to you about how we handle some situations in the church when it comes to us.
Amen.
Go ahead.
I wonder what is the grace it takes in me for now. I should call her. That one is hard. Answer your phone, Lamar. Yes, Sister Gracie, you say I should call. What? What you say? Who pregnant? You're posted man. In a church? Well, Pastor Ketadella now got dead now? Oh, she teach her for Sunday school. No, no, missus. All the time she out the door, wrap up. And we talk about Pastor Ketadella come say, don't leave her alone. See them now? They love talk about me. And look there. Who pregnant now? And who usually on that coconut tree? Oh, Jesus. So what you say, Pastor Ketadella do what? Sister Gracie, you're a lie. Pastor Ketadella, some she must come at church, see how we so hold on, when me beg her to make me sing for the praise team, she said no. Make Sister Jessica do it. Yes, see what Sister Jessica do now? Shame her. Dry, dry, dry. So, anyways, missus, talk to you later.
Yes. That's
so that's how we handle a young lady getting pregnant in the house of God. But I want her to show you how we should handle when somebody fall.
Hello? Yes, I heard about Sister Jessica getting pregnant, but it's not something for us to scatter. Things do happen. No, we don't need to talk like that. She grew up in the church, but accident happened. Yeah, young people of today, so what does that mean? What would God do? Come on now. Should we tear her down? Okay, hold on, hold on, hold on. Listen, listen, listen. If it was your daughter, what would you do?
Amen.
No, no. We just have to encourage her. My mother always say, first time is mistake, second time is purpose, and third time a bright, you're bright. Pray for her. We're going to encourage her because we don't want her to go do the second and the third. God said we must bring them in, pray for them, and He will transform them. Okay,
yes.
So let's pray. Let's not tear our down.
Yes.
Amen. Keep your hands together. put her life at risk for her people. And when it was time for her to see the king on behalf of her people, and she asked that they be fasting and prayer, God came through for Esther.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus of mercy. Amen was hung on his own gallows.
Yes.
Oh, Savior divine.
Yes.
Mordecai was promoted in the palace.
Amen.
You can choose if you want to be a Mordecai or you want to be an Amen. Be careful of the gallows that we are preparing for other people. We might just end up on that same gallows. So Esther's purpose was fulfilled in the palace. She accomplished what God had called her to do. She did not let her circumstances hinder her. Is your purpose being fulfilled? Can God depend on you? Can God favor you? What it is that God called you to do? Are you doing it? What is your story? What are you writing on the pages of life? What will be said about you? What is being said about you now? If the question should be asked about you, what would the answer be? Is God pleased with you? What is your story? Esther had her story.
Yes, amen.
When that roll is called up yonder, hallelujah.
Jesus.
And when the King of Kings open, what will be read about you? What will he be able to say? Thou good and faithful servant? Or will he say, depart from me? I never know you. You were in church for 30 years, but I don't know you. Because we see in churches today, you know, we make it about everybody else. I'm so sick and tired of hearing about somebody else. Nobody wants to talk about themselves. None of us, we don't want to see ourselves. It's always about somebody else. Somebody did something to me. But God wants us tonight to examine ourselves. The blaming game will not work on that day. So ask the Lord to use you tonight. Say, oh Lord, don't refuse me. For surely there's a work that I can do. And even if it's humble, Lord, hallelujah. Help my will to crumble. It's about time. So let's talk about a few people, about their story. Miriam, in scripture, she had her story. Her name means bitterness. She was a leader of God's people. And at a crucial moment in history, she led the celebration after crossing the Red Sea.
Yes, yes, yes.
She spoke God's word to his people, sharing their 40-year journey through the wilderness, but was struck with the leprosy for her pride and her insubordination to her brother Moses. She was denied entry into the promised land. That is Miriam's story. What is your story? Deborah was a prophetess who heard from God. She believed him. She was very courageous. When Israel was spiritually malnourished, she stepped up to the challenge. Israel was oppressed by its enemies. God spoke to her. She called on Barak to lead the people. But he was a little bit afraid. And he said, I will not go unless you are leading. That's her story. What is yours? Potiphar's wife had her story. She was the wife of a prosperous and influential Egyptian. She was unfaithful and vindictive, ready to lie in order to protect herself. And wound an innocent man, Joseph. What is your story?
I don't know.
Sarah was childless for most of her life. It was at the age of 90 that she gave birth to Isaac, a child of promise. And we are complaining that I'm 25 and I don't have a baby yet. I don't see my husband yet. Sarah had a story. What is yours? Agar. Her name means fugitive. She was taken from her homeland, Egypt, to become a slave in a foreign land where she was mistreated. Is that everybody being mistreated for many years? You know the story how Sarah gave Agar to her husband Abraham to have children? Big mistake. Oh, hallelujah. Bad move. You don't do that. And after she did all of that, there's problem, trouble. Agar had to run and hide. I don't think anybody would do that in this time and age. The Shunammite woman, she had her story. She was generous and hospitable. She was a wealthy and capable woman who showed great kindness to one of God's prophets, Elisha. My take is that she's a great woman. Because any woman can convince their husband to build another room for another man. Must be a great woman. I should go to Bishop and say, you know what? There's this man, you know, I really like him because he's a man of God too. I think we need to build another room on the house.
Maybe it's not.
It wouldn't happen, eh? So she was a great woman. Because she did convince her husband and the room was made. And when Elisha comes into town, that's where he was resting his head. Oh, bless the Lord. She has a story. Hallelujah. Jabez had a story. will be told. And it is at a time when that casket is rolled in here, somebody will write a story about your life. And listen to my story. I was born in a little place called Lampard, in the parish of Clarendon, in the island of Jamaica. I was born on October the 10th, 1957. My parents was Leonard and Doris Smith. That's what people talk about you when you die. So between that time and this time, all the things that they think that are important, they put it in your story. And people are crying and wiping tears. And I've been to Jamaica with some funerals. And some people talk about, I miss him because he used to give me yam and banana. That's their story. What is it that you're writing in your story? What it is that somebody's going to talk about you?
That is the truth.
What will they say? Thank God, sister, Yvonne is gone. I won't miss her. She won't have any use in the kingdom of God. What kind of story are you writing? This time it won't be about anybody else. It will be your story that is told.
Mighty God, mighty God, mighty God.
So I want us to be very conscious tonight that when we leave from here, we will know that we are writing our story. And that God is expecting that he can depend upon us. What will your story say? Think about it for 1 minute. What is somebody, what will they say? Because it is going to happen.
Yes.
It will happen. Because we're not going to stay here forever. And it doesn't end when we get in the ground. There will be another story that will be said on the other side.
Almost.
Amen. Amen.
You see, we waste time in church. Worry about everything else that doesn't have nothing to do with us.
Amen.
And we miss out on telling a story that will benefit somebody else's life. We waste time helping somebody who needs help, ministering to somebody because we are so hurt. But what Sister Joan said and Sister Mary said and somebody said, we are in the palace for such a time as this. Be conscious tonight that as of today, I am writing my story. What will your story be? And unless somebody's lying about you, you are writing it.
Lord.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, tonight. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus. that you are allowing us to write our story that we used to do and say so casually. Because now that we are conscious, that it's not about anybody else, it's all about me. My relationship with my King of Kings. My own personal relationship. I have to take care of that. Nobody take care of that for you. You have to spend time before your God. You have to make an effort to accomplish that purpose that is within you. And I heard somebody said that there's so many graveyards that are filled with people died and died with your purpose. Was it fulfilled? And for most of us, we say we don't know what our purpose is. But if we want to know, we can ask.
Amen, amen.
And God will let you know what it is that He wants done. Yeah. And until you know what it is, just do anything that needs to get done.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because sometimes that's what we find out, that this is not what I want, but that, you know, I might want something else. So just begin, just do what you can for the kingdom of God. Because a day is coming when the King of Kings will come back.
Amen.
And He's coming back with His hands full of reward to give every man according to His work. Amen.
Yes.
Will you stand with me as we sing this? This is my story.
Yes.
This is my song.
Praising
my Savior all the day long. Amen.
Blessed assurance,
oh,
earthen vessel that he has brought to Tabernacle of Praise for such a time as this. Hallelujah. Praise God. May the Duffus God bless you. Exactly what Tabernacle of Praise needs to hear. And so he has sent his servant. And she has released it without any reservations. Thank God. We have prayed. And we will pray that God would minister in this woman's conviction. That he would touch the very core of hearts. And I believe in God that there will be change. Here tonight, including me.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. That I'll be changed. That my story will not be tarnished. That when the pages are written and read,
my God.
It will be clear and sincere.
Yeah.
May God have mercy. May God continue to bless his handmaid. May God continue to strengthen her.
Hallelujah!
And use her for his glory and for his honor. Wherever God leads her and see fit to use her to minister to heaven, God wants her to minister.